Hello and welcome to Food Trail with me, Shubhra Mukherjee. Lucknow has always been very royal in terms of its mannerisms, and this shows in their food as well. So to sample the royalty myself, I have come to Darbar-e-Awadh in Delhi Heart. So come and join me. It is as if time itself has stopped for Lucknow, as it is smitten by the Nawabi culture, its historic importance and architectural elegance. And as food gives a true picture of a land, Lucknow's grandeur can be tasted in its cuisine. Thus, the slightest prospect of experiencing Lucknowi food brought me to Darbar-e-Awadh at Delhi Heart.
Lucknow ka khana dekhiye nawabi khana hai. Ye sab nawab log jo the, ye sab in khanon ko pasand karte the. Jaise korma hai, chicken korma hai, galauti kabab hai, kakori kabab hai. Ye ek jagah hai Lucknow ke paas kakori, wahan ke nawab the, unhi ne kabab banwaya tha kakori. जिसकी वजह से ये फेमस है आज भी, और सबसे ज़्यादा बिकता है काकोरी कबाब। गलौटी कबाब ये भी एक सॉफ्ट कबाब है जो कि लखनऊ से मसाले आते हैं इसके सारे, और वहीं से ही इसका खाबसाला आता है जो उसको बनाता है।
लखनऊ का खाना ही मैम कुछ एक और ही बात है उसकी, और खाने से डिफरेंस होता है, मतलब अलग अलग ही होता है।
Majorly influenced by the Mughals and Middle Eastern cooking techniques, presentation is very important in Lucknowi food. The royal khansamas were trained to give that distinct royal touch and regal look to anything they cooked, making sure that the food looked fit for the kings. Thus, a very high degree of skill was required to cook the elaborate Lucknowi cuisine.
खुशबू, मसालों की खुशबू, लखनऊ में मसालों की खुशबू, जो लखनवी खाने की जो खास पहचान है ना, जो उसकी खुशबू जो निकलती है ना, वो उसकी मतलब जो अलग बनाती है उसको और खानों से।
The cuisine has a long list of non-vegetarian items, out of which the kebabs are a hallmark of Lucknow, the galauti kebab. Finely minced meat mixed with a heady mixture of traditional Lucknowi masalas are rolled and shallow fried until it is moist and tender. Another classic kebab is the kakori. A fine paste of meat is artistically layered on an iron rod and grilled till the smoky flavor is achieved.
Now the galauti kebab over here has a very interesting history to it. Legend has it that the Nawab Wajid Ali Shah of Lucknow, when he was aging and was actually losing out on his teeth, didn't lose out on the passion of eating meat related dishes. So he ordered his khansamas, or the grand cooks that he had, to make meat dishes that used finely grinded meat. So that led to the invention of these kebabs.
The paratha gets a special twist in Lucknowi cuisine. Dough filled with khoya and sugar is flattened and prepared on an inverted tawa, thus the name Ulte Tawa Ka Paratha. The Nawabs and the Maharajas were always fond of mutton. Thus, a luscious Avdi mutton curry made of whole spices, along with a plate of an authentic preparation of dum biryani, were signatures and traditional dishes that couldn't be left untouched.
Now over here, I've just tasted the special of the gosht preparation or the mutton preparation, and I must say, by looking at it, I thought it will be very, very spicy, but now after tasting it, it is not at all that spicy, but it is just full of flavors. It is so aromatic and so tasty. It's just amazing. The flavor has been there because of the heady mixture of masalas that are in it. And obviously, as you can see, there are so many pepper seeds and peppercorns that have been put inside it that just give it the required heat.
Milk is considered auspicious, and traditional dastarkhwan normally ends with dessert made of milk and sugar. Thus, I was served firni, a simple yet elegant rice pudding.
Now, this is the firni that I've just tasted. This is a rice-based pudding with a lot of milk, a lot of sugar has gone into it, and obviously topped off with generous helping of dry fruits. And what better way to end my Lucknowi food trail than by ending it with a firni. So, as I'm heading back to relishing my sweet dish over here, it's over to you, Tina.